Did you like that, Jeffrey?
I don't know what that was. Every week I'm like, what's he gonna play? Is it gonna be the HBO theme from the early 1980s, or what was that?
I mean, who knows? Anyway, welcome to the show. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson.
Know.
I know what it is. I know exactly what it is. It is, I'll tell you later. But this is the second in our video podcast series, and we got great feedback from last week's show. Some of it was about microphone levels. That's why the mic is all up in my face right now.
The reverberation, like that type of feedback.
Yeah.
Actual people saying. Actually, I did read the comments.
You read the YouTube comments?
I read the YouTube comments.
They were surprisingly tame. Right?
They were constructive.
They're very constructive. So if you're watching this on YouTube, we want to thank you guys and girls and wherever you are and whoever you are. We're trying the video thing out. We got a lot of amazing things lined up over the next few shows that I can't wait till you see some cool stuff. But Jeff and I are really excited to join you here. We've got another fun show in store for you, I think, right, Jeff?
You know, it's another busy week. I can't believe it's the end of May already. I was putting together the news for the week, and there's a lot of good stuff happening right now. There's a lot to play.
Yeah, there's earlier in the week, of course, in the U.S., it was Memorial Day, so we were off. And it's weird because, you know, I'm sure like a lot of folks around the world, regardless of what country you're in, whenever you have a holiday, it's like, it's you know, everything's kind of blending together in this work from home habit, right? Would you agree with that?
Yeah. And there's, I mean, a lot of different countries had the U.K. had a bank holiday on Monday. There's a lot of folks, and I was talking to some friends over there, and they're like, we're just at home as well, but we're not answering email.
Right, speaking now. Of bank holiday, speaking of bank holidays, I got to get Graham on again so we can talk about his holiday. He's always on holiday, right? He's probably out.
He's always on annual leave.
Annual leave. That's his shtick.
It's nothing we can do about it. Hey, it's a thing.
You just step. Wait till he shows back up. But we got another fun show for you. Again, we are doing video. If you're listening to the audio version of this, you can swing over to my YouTube channel, and I'll put a link down below, and you can see us and hear us. So whichever way you want to get us.
I apologize in advance. Yeah, I had to think about wardrobe today. Like 10 minutes ago,
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh,
look at this.
That's old kit.
Soccer jersey. I miss sports. Actually, we have sports back. We got sports back last.
Somewhat, weekend. Right? Somewhat.
Well, German soccer is back. Yeah. And you know what? All of a sudden, I'm a huge German soccer fan.
You know what? You were FC Cologne anyway.
FC Cologne. I mean, I've been there. I love the gummy bears. I love the Kolsch. And I love the Messe. So
and the people. And the people.
It is.
Yeah.
Of course, they're all very nice.
You know, it's funny.
And so a couple of 2-2 draws later, I'm all in.
I also have, if you look behind me, I've got my console.
I have been playing, where is it?
Golf with friends. Golf with friends.
Oh, I saw you playing that.
And a lot of fun.
Am I not one of your friends now? Because I didn't get the invite.
You're too busy. You know, we play our daily Apex, and I've been playing that a little bit just by myself. It's a miniature golf game. For those of you who don't know, miniature golf is
okay. So you did invite me so you could play golf with friends without friends. Is that correct?
Well, now that you put it that way, it's awkward. Yes. I'm playing golf with friends. With
it's
no
like
friends.
Golf alone.
Well, it's got that option.
Why don't we play? I don't play regular golf. It's not for me. I love video game golf. Hot Shots Golf is one of my favorite games.
Yeah.
Mario Golf. Huge fan of those games. I was playing Power Star Golf.
Did you ever play Outlaw Golf? Outlaw Golf?
You know, I remember Outlaw Golf. I had it on the OG Xbox. I didn't spend a ton of time with it.
Yeah.
But I mean, golf for outlaws. What else could you want?
So yeah, I've been playing that. You can see my console. I just redid my entire home office so that everybody, you know, so that you can enjoy it. I've got, you know, kind of like Jeff has his console behind him. Mine's directly behind me. I've got all my stuff over here. But I've been playing golf, baseball. We talked about the baseball game last week. Super Mega Baseball 3. And you and I haven't played that either. So we need to get to that.
So we work with someone who was a former baseball player, minor leagues. You probably wouldn't know him. And
did he ever have a trading card? We should ask. Did he have a trading card?
He has shoes. he's super into Super Mega Baseball. Like every day he's just like, sorry, I'm gonna have to miss this meeting. I'm in the playoffs right now.
Right.
And I've got a no hitter going, and I'm sorry. And now he's going into season two. But apparently, Super Mega Baseball, which despite its cartoonish looks. I was reading an article.
Is he playing?
From Sabbath, is he playing? Sarkar. Oh no, he's playing a ton of it.
Okay.
And apparently, like really, like it takes a step forward. It's like an amazing baseball game.
Yeah.
And So I need to get into that.
So yeah,
but I playing, always loved RBI back in
the day. Also a great game. But yeah, we're playing. We're talking about what we're playing. We kind of I don't know, wandered into it. Usually it's like, hey, what are you playing? We just kind of wandered into it. You can kind of see on my most recently used back there. I've got they call that MRU. Of course, Minecraft Dungeons. Let me pull that up here. Minecraft Dungeons. You can see I've been playing that. Apex. Golf with friends. So those are kind of what's keeping me busy this past week. Because Minecraft Dungeons, Jeff. I know that you love that, right? You've been playing a lot of that.
I've been playing a ton of Dungeons. I'm playing on multiple platforms. You can see it behind me right over there on Xbox One. There, I'm up to the final. Actually, earlier today I was playing and I was soloing because I just wanted to get some time in.
There it is. What level are you?
I made it to the Archillager. Level 21, I want to say. I got some great gear, but I was wiped out by the Archillager. So, but it's fun enough to just go through. I played some of the same levels again and again. Why don't we play together?
We should. In fact, I was playing over the weekend. I jumped into Phil's game. Phil Spencer, he was on, so we jumped in. We were playing for a little bit, and he loves the game, and we were having a ton of fun with it. And that Archillager is no joke. Okay,
no joke. Not. I don't no spoilers, but when you think of a final boss guy, think of Final Fantasy, how those tend to go, and you can think about some of the challenges there. And then also, you can see behind me a Nintendo Switch. I've been playing on Switch as well, and I rolled another character there, and it's just like. While I'm watching FC Cologne and the Bundesliga, also just having the game just like gets under your skin. And I'm like, you know what? I could go. I have a half an hour, an hour. I'm going to just make a run. And even if I don't win that particular level, I'm probably getting some new gear. I'm probably leveling up. And it's just it is always just like this just one more level mentality,
which is a sign of a great video game. Right. We've all had that.
Exactly, and I've seen on Twitch and on Mixer and on YouTube, like a lot of creators have been playing it and they're really into it. And I think seeing Minecraft in just this different dimension, literally, has just really resonated with folks. And so it's really fun. But we need to play together. I had a meeting a couple of days ago with our manager within Dungeons, and we had a heck of a time. And I will say, if you're finding it too easy, just when you start the level, hit the right bumper once. Just once, even really, and you sort of like increase the level of enemies that come at you and the types of enemies that come at you, and you increase the loot. And it's a whole new game when you're playing on a higher difficulty level.
I've got, it's funny you talked about the Switch. You can't see it. It's actually right back here. Yeah, I don't have the multicolored one, but that's my Switch back here. So I've been trying to check it out on that as well. So not to be outdone by you, Jeffrey.
It's portable. It's to go. Look, we're gamers. We play everything. We play on everything, and the idea. That we can play a game we love. Unlocking achievements on the Switch. I mean, you could do it with regular Minecraft as well. I believe Ori Definitive Edition. Always an interesting experience. But you load up your Xbox app and it is right there.
We've got what else are you playing? Because we want to roll into the news because it's been a busy, busy news week, hasn't it?
Yeah, Larry. I am now two things actually. So yes. I beat Yakuza 0.
Yeah, you did.
This was a game. I get it now. I get it. Like when we announced, I had played Yakuza. I think at Tokyo Game Show, I played like Yakuza 3, like 10 years ago.
By the way, it was. That's where you play Yakuza.
That's where you play, right? And I was just like, I don't get it. People keep picking fights with it. I just didn't get it.
Right.
And
you were younger back then. You've matured.
I'm wiser, and you know what? Giving things a chance is something that I think everyone like I've gotten maybe a little bit better at.
Everyone should do it.
This game drew me in. The story, it's so good, and it only got better as it went along. I think I played, my final clock time was like 38 hours, give or take, and it sucked me into the world. I think it was, it's very over the top. It's very hilarious. It's these guys who... All they do is smoke and drink and eat ramen. And then like someone picks a fight with them and they literally rip their suit off and they're like, oh, ripped. And like, and then they fight. Like at what point? I think there was 100 enemy gangsters come up and I'm like, and my guy's like cracks his neck. And he's like, I got this. I'm like, they have guns and knives and swords. And he's just like, no, we're good. And it's just it's got, so over the top.
So it's got the drinking, amazing. it's got the smoking, it's got the ramen. I mean, at the end of the day, it's like a weekend at your house, less the smoking.
Yes, less than, no, I'm asthmatic. I can't do that. But they actually have like the product placement somehow it's charming in the game.
Charming.
Like, there's like real Yamazaki whiskey in the game, and there's real like
you love that game.
I don't know.
You're a fan.
So
now.
Anyway, I finished it, yep. And then I went and I downloaded Yakuza Kiwami, which is the next in sort of the line. It's a remake of the original Yakuza from like way back in the PS2 days. And so that'll be next. But yep. Before that, I was like, I need to have a palate cleanser. And we talked about this last week. What hit Xbox Game Pass?
Was?
Alan Wake.
Alan, oh, which you had never played. You admitted you had never played it.
So I found this. I bought Alan Wake in 2010, 2011. It still has the plastic on it.
Oh my.
And I never got around to it, but I love the idea of it.
Right.
So now I just downloaded it and I've been playing it and it's really good.
Yeah.
This is not a surprise to most of you out there who've played it. But if I played Control last year, it was my favorite game of the year, and you can see.
Yeah, you can see what they did.
What led into Control. It's like, oh, they did that first in Alan Wake. As the folks at Remedy. And there's even some of the same voice actors in a couple of different places. So really into that. It's like the right level of creepiness. I wouldn't call it horror, a couple jump scares, but just the right level of creepiness and supernatural stuff. And man, they can weave a story, Remedy.
They sure can.
Very, very much like it. So, and it's divided up into like nice episodes. So I think I'm in like episode 3 or 4.
Excellent.
And it even starts with a last time on Alan Wake.
Last time on Alan Wake. Yeah.
That's pretty good. Was that you? Did you do the voice?
I could have. I don't remember.
Yakuza today. Does that as well. So anyway, that's what I've been playing.
So how far are you in Alan Wake?
Again, chapter or act maybe 3 okay. or so.
Yeah.
But just very into it. Great voice acting.
You probably appreciate it more now that you live in the Northwest, because it's got a very Northwest vibe with the fog and the darkness and the dankness and the trees and all of that, right?
Yeah, it seems like very. If I ever left like a 3 square mile, even before we were in quarantine, I never went like north of the mall or south of the airport or east of where we work. And so I live in like this very urban bubble. And so I was like, oh, maybe I should get out to the Olympic Peninsula.
In fact, it's such an urban bubble that you don't even come out to my house. I have to come to you.
I don't know where you live, Larry.
That's not true. Invited.
Like a vampire, I must be invited to come.
Yeah. But so I'm glad you're enjoying Alan Wake. Glad you're enjoying
it. No, it's great work. And check it out. It's on Xbox Game Pass. There's no reason on Xbox and on PC.
What are you doing?
The PC version has some great settings. I was able to run that in 4K, but I started on Xbox One, and I'm going to see it through.
All right. So that's what you're playing. That's what I'm playing. We've got anything else before we roll into the new segment with all the great news that's been coming out?
We can do that. I just wanted to say cheers to you, my fellow Champion Squad member. We're having a pretty good season 5 at Apex. We won last night.
That was a little bit of a surprise, that win. I mean, you've been playing and winning a lot more than I have, but the wins, I mean, I think you and I have a pretty good high win percentage, and last night's was a little bit of a surprise. We had, let's put it this way, the winds were all blowing in our favor from the weapons to the circle.
It was undeserved.
Yeah, well, it was.
Yeah, so we were playing, and the circle came to us. We had high ground, and we had great stuff, and we're like, let's just wait.
Yeah,
and we see someone come, and I'm like, all right, well, there's one player, and we're like, where's the teammates? And I actually hit them a couple times, broke their shields, they healed. Then they came back. Me and you were on the roof.
Yeah, that's right.
They had Kraber, which is the most powerful sniper rifle in the game. They one-shot me, 290 damage. They one-shot you, 290 damage. We're like, how are we getting worked by this
right.
one person?
So we get revived.
And then we did, but it took all three of us to take this one person down.
Oh, yeah, so it was basically 1v3, and we ended up taking him down. But it was whoever that is, you put up a good fight. You have nothing to be embarrassed about.
Yeah. No, not at all. Fortune favors the bold. I'm sure they have plenty of wins under their belt, more than we do. So, anyway.
We've got a bunch of stuff coming up in a little bit. We're going to talk about news. It's been a pretty hefty news week, right, Jeffrey?
Yeah, so I mean, leading off with Minecraft Dungeons, it is available now. It's part of Xbox Game Pass. You can use Xbox Game Pass Ultimate to play Dungeons on Xbox One or on your Windows 10 PC. Also available on PS4. Also available on Switch.
Yeah.
So this game comes to you, no matter where you're at, and I highly recommend you check it out, especially if you're on Game Pass. It's just give it a shot. It's just amazing how well the Minecraft world adapts to a dungeon crawling game. It's smooth, it's fun, it's super chill. And I mean, honestly, I love doing the show, Larry, but if I wasn't on the show right now, I'd be playing it right now.
Likewise, likewise. And you know, you can see the ticker down below. These are some headlines that are coming off Xbox Wire, which I think I've got here if you want to take a look at it, Jeff. If you want me to bring it up, let me bring that over here. So this is Xbox Wire. Old thing? Yeah, this whole thing. Take a look at it. Take a look at all this news. This sits right next to, if you click on the top here, you can go over to MajorNelson.com, which is also a popular
destination. We are the peanut butter and chocolate together here, Larry.
We absolutely
are. Yeah, so we just had a story out there today where Jason Ronald, who we've seen, he's the well-bearded individual who is the director of program management for Xbox Series X, delving super deep into backward compatibility. And the headline, I think, says a lot. You just had it up there, which was thousands of games will be available to play at launch on Xbox Series X, the most powerful and most compatible Xbox console ever, which is amazing. So
I mean, you probably
I'm playing Alan Wake right now. You know, I think that's a great example of it.
You've probably seen this on Twitter, but you can go check out. It's a pretty lengthy piece there about what's going on in terms of backcompat. And you know, the backcompat team. We've been talking about them for years, right? Talk about them for years.
They are nothing short of wizards.
Right. They are. You're absolutely right. They're nothing short of wizards. They are. What's going on there?
Are they in that middle area? That's where the wizardry lives.
That's the wizard box, Jeffrey. That's the wizard box. Oh, boy. It's what happens when you're running your own show.
I know, right? You should have Jason Ronald on the show at some point.
You know what? That is a great idea. When we had him on, last time I had him on, I think was February, where we were talking about Quick Resume and some of those things. And you know what? Be right back. Go keep talking about the news, Jeffrey. I am going to go ahead and see if I can book him while we're chatting.
Shoot him a note. Yeah.
Would you like to do that?
So, right. So something that Jason had, was talking about in this post, and I highly recommend you read it because he says these things much better than I do. But basically, Xbox Series X hardware will running with the full power of the CPU, the GPU, the SSD. It's not boost mode or downclocking. All of that will be applied to your backward compatible games. And that means that they run at peak performance. It means they take advantage of the SSD to load faster.
They run even better than they originally did, right? In some cases.
Funny. Yeah. Like the load screen that used to be there is just like, what? Oh, I didn't, you know, sometimes they would have like tips, something for you to read while you're essentially staring at a load screen. It's like, I didn't get a chance to read that.
Well, I don't know what I was playing, but I was in the lab and we were playing on Xbox Series X, one of the backcompat games. It was exactly that. I ended up loading the game I went to the game and I'm waiting for it to load and I was reading the tips and it's waiting for me. The game was waiting for me. I completely forgot because it was so fast. So it was
funny. We've gotten used to it's just sort of like built into your brain that you load up a game. There's going to be some time. Sometimes I'll look at my phone or I'll just, you know, I'm just getting a drink while it's playing through the initial. It's like you said, oh, wait, the game is waiting for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to play right away.
I'm now the slowest part of the game now, which I feel terrible about that. Anyway, keep going on with the news. What else we got? That's the big piece. Sure. And you probably saw it on Twitter and over on Reddit and all sorts all over the place. So take a look at that article. We've got a really good article. And I'm just sending an email to Jason. So I'm going to see if I can get him on.
So are you in the Project X Cloud preview, Larry?
Why, yes, I am, Jeffrey. Thank you for asking.
Of course you are.
Viewer and listener, are you?
Are you? Yes. And you can look up and if you're running an Android device, you can get right on in there. Mm-hmm. Five new games added. So Batman Arkham Knight, Pillars of Eternity, Mortal Kombat X or 10, if you insist, Ori and the Will of the Wisps. Sure.
Wait, what?
Go ahead and play it right there in, in Project X Cloud. And in Batman 3, Lego Batman 3, Return to Gotham. So if you like realistic Batman or Lego Batman, Project X Cloud has you all set. But there's already a ton of games in there, so another five. And these are big name titles. And
good game titles.
A very new title as well. So that's in the Project X Cloud preview for Android. We have it linked out in Xbox Wire, where you can just go to the Project X Cloud registration page. It's right there on Xbox.com, but we can link out to that, and you should be able to find it. It's just a search and a click away.
Yeah, I want to make sure that, in fact, we do have that available, and I want to thank everybody who has had a chance to test it out, because we're doing this in concert with you, the community. You're helping us make this product better. That's the awesome part about having it in a beta and getting the feedback, and the team listens.
Look at the bottom. Look what it says.
Right there. See, that's
your cloud. The cloud worked out.
It's all happening. This is, I don't know how this is. I don't know what's going on here, but here we are. Yeah. So anyway, xCloud.
You designed it. Your whole system is working.
For now.
Let's not take it for granted. So this was the one of the most visited. I work on Xbox Wire. We don't just do this all.
Not only do you work on Xbox Wire,
as much as we can.
He authors some fantastic stuff over there. Jeff is a prolific writer.
Not as much as I used to. I love writing. Writing's fun. So games. Look, I can't make a game. It's very few people have the talent out there to make a game.
Yep.
Talking about a game.
All day long. That's how I've made my
love to do it.
career.
Seriously. One of the busiest, most visited blog posts this week was Games with Gold. People love to know what they're going to be getting because we're almost at the end of the month. It's almost June, if you can believe it.
Is it?
And so it doesn't feel like it, does it? So Shantae and the Pirate's Curse is coming out for Xbox One. And then we've talked about backwards compatibility, but we're talking about when Xbox Series X comes out, four generations of backward compatibility. And here's a great example. Destroy All Humans from the OG Xbox.
I love that game.
Is going to be available June 1st for free as part of Xbox Game Pass.
You just
get it. As part of Xbox Gold and Xbox Game Pass Ultimate. Look, you got it right there. That's what I'm looking at. Then a great shmup, shoot 'em up, Cinemora in the second half of the month, along with Coffee Talk.
Which
came out not that long ago. That's an independent game. I mean, I'm drinking coffee. We're talking. We're in no position right now to be saying any.
Where's my espresso?
Maybe I need it's my. Like this. Maybe.
I need my espresso, Jeffrey. I need it.
Right. Where is your espresso?
I don't know.
Do you make your own espresso? I think you have a. Do you have like an espresso machine?
Yeah, I have an espresso. You and I have talked about this, and you always poo poo me because you're Mister. You're Mister. Oh, I gotta measure it just so. I'm going to, 2 grams. Oh, 3 grams.
If something's convenient, I just have it in my mind that it's not as good when it's
that, which is which
I should rid myself of that.
E and I, when he was on the show, would have this conversation all the time. It's consistent and it's good enough for me. I don't have a very sophisticated palate when it comes to espresso or coffee. So I'm just happy to get something down my gullet.
That matter.
Hey,
potatoes, man.
What is that all about?
Your sophistication is in, tech, mm-hmm. is in gadgets, mm-hmm. is in home networking. That's where you can
Toilet seats?
From your mouth to God's ears, Larry. But for me, it's coffee. No, home network, whatever the house came with.
But there is one area that I do excel at that, you know, you've got your love of coffee, and you know what mine is, and it's kind of weird. Ice. Right? We've talked about this before. I have this thing for really, really high quality ice. So
if you want to know what it's like to work with Larry, it's he will go. There's a specific. He has to go to a specific floor of a specific building at work. One of the break rooms has a machine that has the ice that you like. It reminds me of like those like bowling alley, like old soda machines where like the cup would come down.
Well, this is the soft pebble ice. Yeah. My favorite ice are the square cubes done by a very, very finicky machine that we don't have on campus. I've only found two of them in Seattle so far.
Oh, really?
At restaurants.
You know where they do great ice?
Where?
Japan.
Oh, yes. They do the spherical ice. They do. It's an artwork unto itself.
They're decades ahead of us when it comes to ice.
In so many ways, right? I mean, they were wearing face masks years ago, so.
They have the Toto toilet. Larry, you should be spending more time in Japan. I would love to go to Japan with you. We would have a great time.
We've talked about that. You know, one of my greatest afternoons in Japan was when I got to spend it with our good friend David Abrams, GPD.
Oh, GPD. Yes.
He took me to the Toto showroom in Shinjuku.
Did he really?
Yes, we just spent an entire afternoon there. It was unbelievable.
Was this like the era before Instagram? Because otherwise there would be a lot of photo. I would love to have seen that.
Yeah, it was. And it was in the skyscraper. It was like on the 20th floor or something. It was great. I had to be buzzed in. It was like, you had to know the secret knock. It was very.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was. Well, it was not for the faint at heart. But anyway, this is the other podcast.
Yes. Japan Tourism Today, our other mm-hmm. podcast. We'll cross promote that.
Like and subscribe.
So another story that was really popular this week, and I'm really excited about it. No Man's Sky is coming to Xbox Game Pass for console and PC this June. So there's a big update coming with it. And so beyond like there was the Beyond update, which came in 2019. They've continued to provide regular free updates to the game. So the Living Ship update hit in February. There was an Exomech update in April. So suffice to say, if you haven't played No Man's Sky either since launch or in a long time, even if it's been a year when it first came out on Xbox One, or it might have been 2 years. I remember one of the very first Inside Xboxes we had some folks from the No Man's Sky team.
We had Sean on, yeah.
Sean Murray.
Yeah.
And well, anyway, so that will be coming. It's to Xbox Game Pass. You have no reason not to try it. Or and that try is, it again.
That is a game that I if you're on Game Pass, please try it out, because it's one of those games where, I don't know, Jeffrey, I remember this, where it was one of the few games where you really got the feeling you were leaving you were taking off from a planet and going into the atmosphere. It was so magical the way they did it. It just felt so, it was just seamless. It was like I was actually flying.
Yes, yeah, going from the planet and out. Yeah, from the surface out into space and back again.
Yeah, it was. And when you land, I love that game. So many, I love that game. So much fun.
I never finished it.
I never finished it either. I just had a lot of time to play it. I just never finished it. So.
Yeah. No, I've definitely put in probably 15, 20 hours. But then I just was scanning everything. And you know what? I was perfectly happy to do that.
Yep. Do it. Get your jollies where you can.
This is a little bit different.
Yes.
Well, sure, fair enough. So we announced the Xbox Family Settings app is going into preview. And so this is, actually, I have it on my phone, so I'll bring it up and I'll show it to you. The first 10,000 people on iOS can download it and try it out. So here it is. It's the Family Settings app. And I use it. This is how I regulate my kids' time. And it's really cool. You can see how much she's played today. Right now, school is still in session. I mean, even though she can't
hasn't played that much,
she's doing school, so she hasn't played today. But I can look throughout the week. I can set how much time she's allowed to play on a particular day. And if she goes over that limit, then she can request more time, and it'll send a notification right to the phone, and I can go, no, you've played enough, or go ahead.
Then you hear the screaming from upstairs.
30 minutes. Yeah.
No!
I'm like, this is, you know, it's a good, nothing beats, as a parent, like knowing what your kid is playing, knowing how much they're playing, and being involved in what they're doing. But this is a great tool to help keep track, because we're all busy and we're all doing a lot of things. We're all working from home, we're learning from home, playing
at
home.
All of it.
And so having this extra tool is really handy. So you can go ahead and you can search for it on the iOS store or also on Android store. You could try it out. It's the Xbox Family Settings app.
Blog post for that over at Xbox Wire. So go ahead and check that out if you would like to, right?
Yeah, it's just sign in. And if your child already has a separate child account, you should just see them right there. If it's already connected with yours. If not, you can sign up for a new account there. You can connect them. There's really a lot of different tools you can do there, and there's more stuff to come. Your feedback is welcome. I think that's the key thing here. Try it out. Let us know what you think. There's actually a feedback bubble that will show up. You can just click it and you can send a note. The team that's making it, they will read it and, you know, hopefully make the app better for you.
That's important. Again, it's about doing it with the community, working on things with you, the community, and we would love to have your help in making this app the best, frankly, the best app we can do for your kids and helping your kids and being a great parent too, which is also important.
You're a parent. Your baby's not playing yet, but she will.
No.
And when she's not going to?
Well, we'll see. You know, I want her to do whatever she wants to. If she wants to play, she can play. You know, when she's old enough to make her own decisions, right? Look, I'll just say it's, you know, I don't.
At some point, we're gonna need. You're gonna need. You're golfing alone. You should golf with friends or your kid.
So, I'm telling you. You should be playing. I also, you know, you and I play frequently Apex, and your daughter is usually the third, and she's quite good. She's quite good. So I don't. I just don't know if my daughter's
better than I am. Yeah. So you got to work on those reflexes. She's a little young now, but
young and by the way, very aggressive.
So. She's not one to sit back.
No, she's not one to sit back at all. Anyway, what else we got there, Jeffrey?
So we debuted this week a Dev Diary series for Wasteland 3. Very excited that game will be coming out in late August. It's by In Exile. If you played Gears Tactics, If you like a strategy RPG, this game is going to be for you. It's very different than Gears Tactics, where you came in, you fought that battle, and then you withdrew to the base. This strings together a little bit more. It's more of a more story based, I would say. Although I really like the story in Gears Tactics. Anyway, some similar elements. I think if you like one, you like the other. They're not in any way identical. And you can create your own character. And their backstory and a lot of cool stuff. I got to play a stream during, there's a Steam a beta that you can be part of, or backers alpha, I want to say, or backers beta for people that initially backed the game on Fig or whatever the crowdfunding was back a couple of years ago. Well, anyway, game's coming out. If you want to learn more about it, if any of the things I said, like strategy RPG or Gears Tactics,
if piqued your interest. Yeah, if any of those words were like, ooh, they make your ears go up, then that's what you need to do.
Exactly. Definitely looking forward to Wasteland 3. I mean, August, actually it's 3 months from today, I think, as we record this. So it's really not that far away.
Where has this 2020 is something, isn't it?
Seriously.
On so many levels.
Right. Let's talk about, this is the part of the news where we talk about free stuff, and I love free stuff. And I think everyone loves free stuff.
In fact, you know, I feel like I should. I feel like I missed an opportunity to have a little music bed for you. So let's see if I can bring that up. Go ahead. It's going to be plastered up a little bit.
Lost. Oh, you're going to do it all. You're going to do it on the fly. Tea time. Yes.
This is how you get some free things, Jeffrey.
Yeah, you got the yeah, sure. I don't know what we're. I don't know what we're doing. We're definitely. We just lost all your subscribers in the UK. They're like, well, I don't know what this is.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
Sea of Thieves. And the game is made in the UK, so we're really, really landing it. This Sea of Thieves has been the gift that's kept on giving over the past 2 years and change since it came out in 2018. The free Lost Treasures update is available now. It's available now free across Xbox One, Windows 10, Xbox Game Pass. We would revisit the Tall Tales, which is the story-driven adventures. And there's a bunch of new daily bounties, weekly events. It's a whole lot of stuff. So jump back into it. You will always see it. This is a game like we were just talking about, No Man's Sky, that if you haven't played Sea of Thieves in a while, it's not what you remember. There's just so much more going on.
Oh, it's a vibrant,
layered
and beautiful universe. It is. Here's all the information here on Xbox Wire.
We got the video. And
it has cats. And even if you're there, it is. Even if you're allergic to cats, this is a way you can get into the. You can easily on ramp to cat ownership.
My kid really wants a cat, and I'm very allergic.
She needs one. My sister's a veterinarian. My sister's a veterinarian. I will talk to her. Okay. We'll find out what kind of allergy you have, and I'll have her find a kitty for you, or two.
Actually, I would love kitties? That. Because, we're at home a lot. I would love for her to have a pet. And I kind of like cats.
Right.
I just, my...
Kinda. Just by the way, kinda. That's a little disturbing. Else. Kinda like cats. Well, you've never lived with one. Yeah.
Actually, I have. And that went badly. But we're not going to talk about that.
All right. The kitty incident. We're not going to talk about that. By the way, you know what reminds me is you can't really tell, but... out this window right here is a, I've got, we've, okay. We live in a forest, and I didn't send you this though, but I was looking at, we have a video camera surveillance system, and it tripped at like 11 o'clock one morning. And I looked at the video and it was a coyote walking through my front yard into the side here with a chicken in its mouth, a dead chicken. So I, sorry for the guy down the street who's now minus one.
Where do you live?
I'm going to send you the video, and you're going to look at this and go, what? It was the craziest thing. So,
by the way, if you had just said there was a chicken, like that alone would have like thrown me for a loop.
Oh, my funniest experience is we live on top of a hill, and my wife had the funniest experience. She was going up the hill to come home, and she was on the phone with me. And I'll never forget this. It's probably about 6 years ago. And she just stopped talking. I said, are you okay? She's like, and then she bursts out laughing. Running down the middle of the road was a chicken. Dead on the double lines, in between the double lines, straight down the road, and looking over its shoulder.
But not crossing the road.
But not crossing the road, going straight down the road. So it passed her. So to this day, we still call that Chicken Run Hill. So it was the strangest experience. But she still giggles whenever she says it was the funniest thing she's ever seen.
Did I tell you about the wild nature experience that we had a couple weeks ago? Because it was very traumatic, and my kid is.
If you were to say that in Florida, it would be a very different story. But go ahead.
No. All right. So I was down here playing Yakuza, actually, and upstairs, like, my wife is like, "Oh my god, like what?" And so I go upstairs, and a bird had somehow landed. We have like a very small balcony, like literally the size of this desk right here, like very small.
Like, it's like it's kind of like you get in a hotel where you kind of lean out a little bit.
Exactly. Yeah. Very little, but like a little bird had landed there, and I don't know if it was injured or what, but it had to have been, because it wasn't flying out there. So I gently corralled it into a box, and I folded the box.
I never heard the story.
A couple blocks from a park.
Sure.
This was like last week.
By the way, you also live a couple blocks from a zoo. So.
Yes. That's also true. So I walk out the door to take the bird. Like, look, if a bird lands there, I didn't want to touch it, because I didn't know if
birds
have
could be anything, well, right?
And I didn't want it to like not be accepted by its
sure
bird peers. So my daughter's like, "Oh, let me come with," and I'm like, "Okay." So she chases me down, and we walk down, and I find like a clearing, and so
was this up the hill?
It's just in the park nearby. Okay. It wasn't even up there. So I turn the box sideways and I open it up, and we stand back. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, it's like, "Come on out." And I sort of usher it, and it takes like two or three steps. And then I'm like, "Go." And it takes off to fly. And within about 3 seconds, this giant crow comes out of nowhere, and they've grown big here, snatches it out of the air, like in its feet, and like just takes it and just starts.
And your daughter starts crying, I imagine.
Crying, like, inconsolably. And I was like, oh, like, it came out of nowhere. Like, how did it even know it was there? I know crows are supposed to be smart, but it had to have been like.
It was, let me tell you something. We live in an era where there's murders and murders of crows, the proper term. And they are cunning little creatures. So it may have been following you from your house.
How did it know? Anyway, she was devastated. She was just absolutely
as well
devastated.
She should be. That's gonna taint her.
Yeah. So when she's in therapy in 10 or 15 years, that was a contributing factor. I should have just made her stay home.
Well, that's why
it was nature.
Yeah.
But you know, she doesn't want to hear that. It was cute little birdie was just eviscerated by a crow.
Well, that's why I couldn't show my daughter.
Not allowed these bloodhounds.
I couldn't show my daughter the coyote, and that's why I told her. I said, "You can't go out of the house alone. There's coyotes out there." So she's very nervous about the coyotes. Well,
and she's, you know, the road runner. If she's seen those cartoons, she knows you can't outsmart a coyote.
You can't. Yes, exactly. Wiley coyote.
I've got a couple more free things here.
Yes, go over them, including this discussion. Yeah. Completely free.
You're still here. Warface Breakout. So you might have heard of Warface. Warface came out actually on Xbox 360 and available on Xbox One, but this is a different game. And it just came out this week. So it is a tactical FPS action game. It is free to play. It's a new take on the classic defuse the bomb sort of gameplay. And there is absolutely no reason not to check it out. So it is inspired by Counter-Strike. And if you played Warface, this is a standalone spinoff game to that.
Hey, I've got a little something. I'm sorry. You have one more free thing, don't you?
No, that's it. I do have one more free thing.
Go ahead. Take it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Warface is not a free-to-play game. This is a $19.99 standalone game.
All right.
So I sorted my games.
Editor's correction.
Separately. Yes. Thank you. But free play days that you can jump in and you can play. Every weekend, we've had some games that you can play for free. Some cool ones this week. Hunt Showdown.
Yes.
Stellaris.
Yes.
Which I've heard really good things from. Our good friend Pope Eric Pope was a big fan.
Oh, I thought you meant Xbox Pope.
Xbox Pope. He might play it as well.
We don't know.
Designed a controller or a console for it.
Or two or three.
Talented artist. Yeah. And Jump Force as well, which is the sort of Bandai Namco anime flavored fighting game that I remember got a real big pop when it was announced at E3 a couple of years ago.
I remember
that. So those games are available by the time you hear this. To play for free up until Sunday, May 31st, just about midnight. And if you like them, if you play them, you like them, they're all on sale. between 40% and 67% off.
67% off. Can that be, Jeffrey?
Yes.
Can that actually be?
Two-thirds. Again, I think we might have had to round those.
You know, ever since, I've said this many times, ever since Laura left the show, the IQ has basically gone down about 97%. That's the only number I know.
Yeah, it was taken away by the crows as well. They swooped off with
picked off
all the intelligence.
Crows and the coyotes. Oh, brutal. Anyway, what else we got there, Jeffrey? Are we okay this week?
That's it for news.
Yep.
Of course, we'll of course be back next week with news, and I hope you're able to summon a great guest as well.
Well,
with some brains.
Yeah, we're gonna get for some IQ. We gotta pump that back into the show. We've got your screen dimmed behind you. We can't see your character.
Oh my, yes.
I don't know where your controller is.
There you go. No, it's right here.
By the way, I love the fact that you and I have matching chairs. Did you notice that? We have matching chairs. This is the official Xbox chair. Anyway, yeah, we got a bunch of great guests. So if you're subscribed on YouTube, you can continue to do that. You can like and subscribe. You can do that, Jeff, right? You love that when they smash.
No,
the
I
button.
Love when you do that. Yeah. I love when you mash that subscribe button.
If you're listening to this on the normal podcast venues, then like I said earlier, we've got the video version of this up. You can go check it out. Feel free to comment. Love the fact that the comments are for now civil. I hope they stay that way.
Look, so yeah, it'd be nice, but we do read your feedback though. So
right.
If there's something you'd like us to do differently, let us know.
Yeah, so we're gonna
be gentle on our quarantine here. This is.
By the way, did you notice I got a haircut? My wife gave me another haircut.
You know what? Actually, she did a pretty good job.
She did a great job. I wasn't stunned, but I was like, I don't know if I need to go back. You know who I feel for? I feel for all these poor. People at Supercuts and hairstylists that after this is all done and people have to go back, they're going to have to undo all the mess that we've all done to ourselves.
I know. I feel like we should have to pay double or triple because
yeah.
We haven't been able to go and there's going to be just a lot of hair being lopped off. I mean, I'm really relying on this headset. This headset is holding everything together.
And oh, look at that.
It still looks only so-so. Look at that. She did. She picks your wardrobe out too. I mean, you basically have a live-in stylist. She does a lot more than that, but she's taking care of that.
And well, you know, the reason for successful marriage is know what you're good at and know what your partner's good at and do what you're good at and don't do what you're not good at. Like I don't think I've ever told you the story, but when it comes to wardrobe, I have a terrible, terrible habit. If I go out and buy clothes, first of all, she will not let me buy clothes anymore. If I go out and buy clothes, for some reason, I always end up within this very narrow band of rust colored shirts. And I don't know why I keep navigating to rust. So she's like, no. And she throws it out. You've never seen them on me because she won't let me out of the house with them. But like, this is
no,
a nice color. Isn't it?
I don't think I want rust.
Yeah. It's a little because I like orange because I'm an orange man. I don't know.
Because you went to Syracuse. Yeah,
right.
I guess.
Right.
All
right.
Sure.
I don't know. Anyway, it's
left to my own devices. I wear nothing but swag T-shirts and soccer jerseys. So
and I'll tell you this. I can confirm that, you know, you see, in fact, did you notice, Jeff? I shaved today.
You shaved.
Right. We were on a call yesterday and you're like, don't shave. And I'm like, I had to
keep it for the show.
I don't want to.
People like the beard.
No, my wife, my daughter calls it scruffy and she doesn't like it. She's like, it's scruffy. Go take a shower and shave. So what are you going to do?
All right. And you gave in. Look, we all have our, she's daddy's girl.
We'll be back. We'll be back next week with another show. Maybe some special guests. So make sure you stay right where you are. If you want to hit us up on any of the social channels, you know how to find us, right? All you got to do is hit us below. You can see me at Major Nelson. Of course, you can see Jeff. Right there, it's like a Brady Bunch.
Please
thing.
Feel free to send those dungeons invites if you see us in there.
Yeah, if you see us in dungeons, then go ahead and do that, and then we'll. You know what? I'm going to play a little music here. Let's see if I can bring us out. Where's the music, Jeffrey? Can I do that?
Play us out, Larry.
Which brought us in with. All right, gang.
What song is it? What is this?
I'll have to find the link to it. I don't know where.
You just like it. It's just a song you like, doesn't it?
Yeah, I ended up getting clearance for this to use it, so I don't know where it came from.
Oh,
but anyway,
so it's just safe.
It's safe. Okay. All right, gang. We'll see you guys next week. Thanks for tuning in, and have a great gaming week. And whatever you do, stay safe out there. And Jeff and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
See ya.